Gentlemen, Kris Kristofferson with Johnny Cash.
I was a highwayman, long the coach roads I did ride, with sword and pistol by my side. Many a young girl lost her baubles to my trade. Many a soldier shed his lifeblood on my blade. They finally hung me in the spring of 25, but I am still alive.
I was a sailor. I was born upon the tide. With the sea I did abide. I sailed a schooner around the Horn of Mexico. I went aloft to furl the mainsail in a glow. And when the yard broke off, they said that I got killed. But I am living still.
I was a dam builder, crossed a river deep and wide, where steel and water did collide. Called Boulder on the wild Colorado. I slipped and fell into the wet concrete below. They buried me in that great tomb that knows no sound, but I am still around. Yes, I'll always be around.
Across the universe to cry. When I reach the other side, I'll find a place to rest my spirit if I can. Or maybe a highwayman again. Or I may simply be a single drop of rain.
Genius you are, both of you. Of course, you didn't write that, did you?
No, you could everything tell. Else, you
I could tell, tell. Yes.
John sings that song every night. I've never sung it, so it's...
you made a good stab of it tonight.
Well, that's what I would call it, too, a stab.
Listen, Kris, it's a great honor for me to be talking to a distinguished Rhodes Scholar from Oxford University.
You wouldn't put me on, would you?
What the hell were you doing at Oxford University?
I was reading English language and literature at Merton College.
That's amazing. That's why they don't normally talk to me, because my English language and literature is a bit different, you know. But that's another story.
Well, that another lifetime, too.
You bet, yeah. Your father was a general in the U.S. Army?
Yeah, in the Air Force.
Now, in the U.S. Army Air Force, it was called in those days. Don't quibble, Christopher.
Also in the Air Force after the Army Air Force.
Let me tell you something. If you had stayed in the Army yourself, where you were an officer, you would now have been a general in Nicaragua.
Well, No. I doubt seriously that I would have been a general. I would probably have been a serious alcoholic.
The same thing.
And I also would hope that I would not have been in Nicaragua. Because unless I was down there to support the Sandinistas and the Nicaraguan Revolution.
Hey, that's telling. So the plight of the world and of the people there in Central America, that worries you something?
Well, yes, I think any human being has to be concerned especially Americans, if we believe in freedom and self-determination, you know, we have to worry about imposing our will on another nation. It's not a very happy subject for a fun show, is it?
No. Let's talk about your music. You've written
a laugh-a-minute guys here, me and Johnny Cash.
You've written over 150 songs recorded by 450 singers across the world. You know what the greatest was? Saved countless lives, including mine. Tell me what your greatest song was.
I thought you were going to tell
me. You tell me. Help me. Help me make it through the night.
Well, that's been recorded by most people.
That's right. What do you sing it for? Just a bit. Just a bit from the top.
Take the ribbon from your hair. Shake it loose. Let it fall. Laying soft against my skin. Like the shadows on the wall. Come and lay down by my side. Till the early morning light. All I'm taking is your time. Help me make it through the night.
Imagine, eh? You could have been a boxer, a pilot, an army officer, a writer. Why did you pick country music as your specialty, Kris?
I think because country music really brought me back to life. When I went to Nashville and ran into people like Johnny Cash and people who I'd idolized for years, there was something about their spirit that brought me back into a fascination with living. You know, country music was so close to the heart and to the soul that I feel like I fell in love with life again. Up to that point, I might have had sort of a not so sublimated death wish, and even a guy with a death wish like this guy could inspire me to be living.
Both of you really diced with death, didn't you?
Well, we held it at arm's distance.
We held the world record.
We took it to the limit, all right.
Yeah. You with the little pills and you with the booze.
Yeah.
Tell me, when did you first get alongside Johnny? Because you actually sent a demo tape to him, didn't you?
Well, I sent several. In fact, every song that I ever wrote, I gave to John. I first met him backstage at the Opry when I was still in uniform. He probably don't remember that because he was trying desperately to focus his attention, I think.
You're so kind, thank you.
And after that, I was his janitor at Columbia Records for about a year and a half. And I used to pitch every song that I wrote through June Carter and Luther Perkins as a guitar player. And I think John, I found out years later, would throw them in the lake. I knew he wasn't recording them.
Because you didn't
hear. And one day, when I was, after I'd known him a couple of years, I was in the National Guard, and I was out flying an old National Guard helicopter, and I took a tape of a song and landed it on his lawn. I figured I was going to make an impression on it.
You
almost landed on
song.
His house, great. As a matter of fact.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you a secret. This man cares so much that he's going to do a benefit concert for the victims of that psychopathic lunatic in Hungerford, 16 dead. And Kris here is going to raise cash for the victims. That's marvelous. I'm delighted to tell you that the big old moon is shining bright tonight because Billie Joe Spears is here with Blanket on the Ground.
Come on, look out through the window. That big old moon is shining bright. Highwayman here. I've a blanket on the ground. Remember back when love first found us, we'd go slipping out of time, and we'd love beneath the moonlight on a blanket on the ground. I'll get the blanket from the bedroom. We'll go walking once again to that spot where our sweet love first began. Just because we are married don't mean we can't slip around. So let's walk out through the moonlight and lay the blanket on. Just because.